Greetings, Tabor College faculty and staff. This is David Swisher, the LMS coordinator on the Wichita campus. And in this video, I'm going to explain how to record your Zoom sessions and to configure the location where they'll be saved. Okay, so here we're looking at the Zoom interface during a live meeting. And what I'll do is I'll move my mouse over the Zoom interface, and that brings up a set of tools along the bottom. You'll see one over here on the left that says Settings. We'll get to that one in just a minute. The other one is over here, and it says Record. And I will click Record, and you'll notice in the upper left-hand corner, I now have a little black button that with a blinking red light. The blinking red light indicates that the session is being recorded, and then it also has a black button here to stop recording. So when I'm ready to stop the recording, I'll simply click this black button to stop recording. And over here on the right, I get a message that says the recorded file will be converted to MP4 when the meeting ends. That's a fairly common video format. And so far, the meeting has not ended yet, so I'm going to do that now. End meeting. End meeting for all. And then it will pop up a message saying that it's converting that recording file. Here's the message. I have a recording that needs to be converted before viewing. And then it automatically pulls up the folder in which it's housed. In that folder, you'll find an audio-only file. You will find a chat log. There was no chat in this particular one, but if you're using chat, you'll have that as well. This playback.m3u isn't really useful for our purposes, but the biggest one, this one that says .mp4 and has the larger file size, that is the recording file. And if I were to double click that, it will open in whatever default video player I have. Since this is the PC, I'm going to guess that's Windows Media Player.
Record. And you'll notice in the upper left hand corner, I now have a little black button that with a blinking red light. The blinking red light indicates that the session is being recorded.
I think that's enough of that. That's all it takes. Now, if I want to control where those go, what I will do is in my session, I will go over here to Settings, and there's several different options. There's audio settings, video settings, general, but this fourth one here, recording, determines where things go. So this is my location where they are saving. I have created a folder in my documents for Zoom, but if I wanted to, I could click Change File Location, and I could pick any file, any folder anywhere on my hard drive or even on iDrive share space. You can create a folder there to store them in. If I click Change File Locations, then I can browse for where I want to put it. And let's say I want to put it on my desktop. Not a good idea, but just for the sake of showing, click Make New Folder. There we go, new folder. And I can call it whatever I want. Zoom Recordings would be a good name for it. Okay, I'm not going to click OK because I don't want to save it that way. But that's how that would work. There is another option here to choose a location for the recorded files when the meeting ends. So if you are frequently meeting for a number of different purposes and sometimes need it recorded in one folder, sometimes need them to go to iDrive, and sometimes need them to go somewhere else, if you were to enable that, then it's going to prompt you every time you end the session, where do you want the recording to go? And that's all it takes.